गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रेन. सो एज आई हैव कम्प्लीटेड बोथ द बुक्स बी हाइव एंड मोमेंट्स. सो वंस अगेन आई एम टेकिंग एवरी चैप्टर ओके वन बाय वन एंड अगेन एक्सप्लेनिंग इट सो दैट यू कैन अंडरस्टैंड इट बेटर. ऑल राइट, यू कैन टेक इट लाइक अ रिविजन. ओके, सो लेट्स स्टार्ट इट. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, एज चैप्टर नंबर वन फ्रॉम आर मोमेंट्स, द लॉस्ट चाइल्ड. ओके, इट इज़ रिटन बाय मुल्कराज आनंद. With the name of the chapter, you should know who is the writer. Okay, this you also should know. All right, so Mulkraj Anand is the writer here. So before starting the chapter, I just want to give you the introduction. So this is one of the famous stories of Mulkraj Anand. It shows its universal appeal and popularity. It is in fact a study of child psychology. We will see through this story the psychology of a child. Every child is deeply attached to his parents, that he feels very insecure without them. The whole world tumbles down to nothing when he gets lost. Anand narrates the story of a little child who sets out with his parents to a village fair. He gets his first glimpse of the colorful worlds of sweets, balloons, butterflies, flowers, garlands, the mustard fields, the snake charmer's performance and the roundabout. He longs for so many things, but he knows that his parents won't buy him any. When he asks for a joyride on the roundabout, he observes he has lost them in the crowd. A stranger tries to console him in vain. The child loses interest in all the things that attracts him earlier. He only wants to be united with his parents. Okay? So this is the introduction. Let's start the story. Okay. It was the festival of spring. From the wintry shades of narrow lanes and alleys emerged a gaily clad humanity. Some walked, some rode on horses, others sat being carried in bamboo and bullock carts. One little boy ran between his father's legs, brimming over with life and laughter. So here, okay. So in this stanza, what is it given? So here we can see wintry shades of narrow lanes and alleys. Okay, in the winter season, the narrow lanes were full of shades. Okay. Emerged here means came out. Brimming over means to be full of something. Okay, full of something. Okay, so the story is set in the spring season. So here we can understand the season which is given is spring. Okay, sets in spring season. As the winter season had just ended, all the people came out of their houses. They were cheerful. They were very cheerful, okay. As the chilling cold weather had ended, people conveyed through different modes, foot, horses, bamboo carts and bullock carts. A little child was accompanied by his parents. He ran excitedly and often banged into his father's legs. He was full of life, excited and laughter. Come, child, come, called his parents as he lagged behind, fascinated by the toys in the shops that lined the way. So here, lagged behind means was left behind, okay? Left behind. All right, fascinated by means attracted by, attracted to, sorry, attracted to. Okay, lines the way were set up along the way. Okay, they were in the line. So, they were set up. Okay. So, the child was attracted to the toys which were displayed at the various stalls. As he would be left behind, his parents would call him to come with them. He hurried towards his parents, his feet obedient to their call. His eyes still lingering on the resounding toys as he came to where they had stopped to wait for him. He could not suppress the desire of his heart, even though he well knew द ओल्ड कोल्ड स्टेयर ऑफ रिफ्यूजल ऑफ देयर आईज. सो अंडरलाइन द वर्ड्स. लिंगरिंग मीन्स, लिंगरिंग ऑन मीन्स दिस इज लास्टिंग फॉर अ लॉन्ग टाइम. ओके, और वी कैन से लास्टिंग फॉर अ लॉन्ग टाइम, दैट इज लिंगरिंग ऑन. ओके, लॉन्ग टाइम. ओके, रिसीडिंग मीन्स लेफ्ट बिहाइंड एज ही वॉक्ड अहेड. ओके, दे वर बिहाइंड हिम. सप्रेस मीन्स पुट एन एंड टू. ओके, मतलब उसने अपनी जो भी उसको चाहिए था उसने उसको दबा लिया. ओके, सप्रेस मतलब दोज डिजायर्स विच वर इनसाइड. ओके, सो पुट एन एंड. So the child was obedient and would walk towards them on being called, but his eyes would keep on looking at the toys that he wanted. As he reached them, he couldn't control his desire to buy a toy. He was familiar to the reaction that they would give. He knew that they would stare him, indicating denial to buy him the toy. The child knew the emotionless way in which they would stare at him. I want that toy, he pleaded. Pleaded means requested. Okay, the child was unable to control his desire any longer. He said that he wanted to buy the toy. His father looked at him red-eyed in his familiar tyrant's way. So what is it? Tyrant means a cruel and oppressive ruler. Okay, tyrant's way means very cruelly. His mother, here what is given? The father's eyes grew red with anger. He looked at the child just like a cruel ruler who was trying to oppress him. Okay, cruel ruler. Now, his mother, melted by the free spirit of the day, was standard and giving him his finger to hold, said, look, child, what is before you? So what mother is doing, melted means became tender and loving. The mother became emotional due to the cheerful mood. Lovingly, she gave her finger to the child to hold and guided him to a place. She asked him to see what was in front of him. Now, it was a flowering mustard field, pale like melting gold as it swept across miles and miles of even land. A group of dragonflies were bustling about on their gauzy purple wing, intercepting the flight of a lone black bee or butterfly in search of sweetness from the flower. The child followed them in the air with his gaze till one of them would steal its wings and rest, and he would try to catch it, but it would go fluttering. Flapping up into the air when he had almost caught it in his hands. Then his mother gave a cautionary call, come child, come onto the footpath. So here pale means very dull. Okay, P-A-L-E, pale means dull. Or we can say colorless. Okay, gauzy means extremely bright and showy. Okay, that is gauzy. Extremely bright. Bright. Okay, so there was a vast field full of bright yellow colored mustard flowers. They seemed like flowing stream of gold and were widespread. A group of dragonflies, black bees and butterflies buzzed around, sucking the nectar from the flowers. The child looked at them as they flew around. One of the set somewhere, he tried to catch them, but the tiny creature would fly away the next instant. The mother called out to him as they started walking down the footpath. So, the child wanted to catch everything, whatever he was watching, but as he got the call from his mother, he started to walk. He ran towards his parents gaily and walked abreast of them for a while, being, however, soon left behind, attracted by the little insects and worms along the footpath that were teeming out from their hiding places to enjoy the sunshine. So, oppressed here, side by side and facing the same way, teeming out means to pour or empty out. So the child ran towards his parents. He walked next to them, but after a few steps, he stopped to see the insects who were coming out of the soil. Once again, the child was left behind. Now again, come child, come. His parents called from the shade of a grove where they said they had seated themselves on the edge of a well. He ran towards them. Now grove is what? Underline the word. A small wood or group of trees. So here, a group of trees, that is grove. So the parents called him. They sat next to a well under the shady tree. The child once again ran and joined his parents. A shower of young flowers fell upon the child as he entered the grove, and forgetting his parents, he began to gather the raining petals in his hands. But lo, he heard the cooing of doves and ran towards his parents, shouting, "The dove, the dove!" The raining petals dropped from his forgotten hands. So, as the child entered the shady forested area, he was welcomed by the shower of flowers. Okay, young flowers means those little flowers. The shower of flowers, he was welcomed. He forgot his parents and started collecting the petals that had fallen. Okay, so just then he heard the cooing of doves and he again got very excited to see them. He started chasing the birds, and in the process, the petals fell from his hands. This shows that as the child got attracted towards the next thing, he forgot what he had seen, he had been doing earlier. Come, child, come. They called to the child, who had now gone running in wild capers round the banyan tree, and gathered him up. They took the narrow, winding footpath which led to the fair through the mustard field. Now, capers here, a playway skipping movement, that is caper. Alright. What is it? A playful skipping movement. So here, the parents called the child who was running and playing round a banyan tree. They lifted him and walked down a narrow, twisting lane through which they crossed the mustard field and reached the fair. As they neared the village, the child could see many other footpaths full of throngs converging to the whirling of the fair, and felt at once repelled and fascinated by the confusion of the world he was entering. So here, throngs means huge crowd, okay? Thongs means huge crowd, and converging means gathering, okay? This is huge crowd, converging, gathering. So as they were about to reach the fair, the child saw huge crowds of people walking from all directions towards the fair. The dense crowd scared him and stepped back for a while, but the next moment he got attracted to the mind-boggling crowd of humanity. Okay, so now what he has seen there, a sweetmeat seller, hawker, gulab jamun, rasgulla, barfi, jalebi at the corner of the entrance, and crowd pressed around his counter at the foot of an architecture of many colored sweets decorated with leaves of silver and gold. The child stared up open-eyed, and his mouth watered for the barfi. That was his favorite sweet. "I want that barfi," he slowly murmured, but he half knew as he begged that his plea would not be heeded, because his parents would say he was greedy. So without waiting for an answer, he moved on. So heeded means paid attention to, without paying any attention. Okay, so at the entrance of the fair, to one corner, a sweetmeat seller had set up a shop, and what he was having, he was selling various sweets like gulab jamun, rasgulla, barfi and jalebi. So the sweets were displayed at different heights and were covered with foils of gold and silver. The boy's mouth watered when he sighted his favorite barfi. He expressed his desire to get one in a low voice because he knew that his request would be refused by his parents. They would say that he was greedy for the barfi, as he did not expect that his demand would be fulfilled. He walked further. Now next he see a fla sela hogged a garland of gulmohar. The child seemed irresistibly drawn. He went towards the basket where the flower lay heaped and half murmured, "I want that garland," but he well knew his parent would refuse to buy him those flowers because they would say that they were cheap. So without waiting for an answer, he moved on. So again, the next stall was that of a flower seller. He announced that he was selling garlands of gulmohar flowers. The child wanted one of those. He walked towards the basket of flowers and again announced his desire to have one in a very low voice because he knew that his demand would not be fulfilled. They would refuse to buy him the flowers as they would say that they were cheap. Again, the boy walked ahead without expecting a reply from his parents. Now, what he see next? A man stood holding pole with yellow, red, green and purple balloons flying from it. The child was simply carried away by the rainbow glory of their silken colors, and he was filled with an overwhelming desire to possess them all. But he well knew his parents would never buy him the balloons because they would say he was too old to play with such toys. So he walked on further. So overwhelming means a very strong emotion. Okay, a very strong emotion that he just want to have those balloons. Okay, so the next thing that the child came across was a balloon seller selling balloons of different colors of the rainbow. The boy was attracted to the shiny colors of the balloons and wanted to have them all. He knew that his parents would not buy the balloons for him, as they would reason that he was too old to play with them. So the child walked further. Now next thing he see, a snake charmer. A snake charmer stood playing a flute to a snake which coiled itself in a basket, its head raised in a graceful bend like the neck of a swan, while the music stole into its invisible ears like the gentle rippling of an invisible waterfall. The child went towards the snake charmer, but knowing his parents had forbidden him to hear such coarse music as the snake charmer played, he processed further. Now what he sees next? The snake charmer. Forbidden means, Peter, not allowed. Okay, this is not allowed. Coarse means unpleasant. All right, coarse means unpleasant music. Okay, so then he paused at a snake charmer who was playing a flute, and the snake was twisting its neck to the music. The snake had coiled itself in a basket and had raised its head out. It bent and moved its neck gracefully like a swan. It seemed that the music of the flute was heard by the snake's invisible ears. So it was looking like that and created the effect of waterfall on it because it swayed its neck in a similar way. The boy walked towards the snake charmer, but as his parents had warned him to remain away from the unpleasant music played by such men, he walked further. Then next thing he has seen, it was there was a roundabout in full swing. Men, women and children carried away in a whirling motion, shrieked and cried with dizzy laughter. The child watched them intently and then he made a bold request. I want to go on the roundabout. Please, father, mother. So this time he has raised his voice for roundabout. So then he saw the roundabout swing. It was full of men, women and children who were enjoying the ride. The boy watched the people on the roundabout and then with a lot of courage expressed his desire to go on the roundabout. All right, so he requested his parents, his father and mother, let him go there. All right, children, so I'll end here. This is part one. Okay, now in my next video I'll upload part second. Okay, till the time go through this chapter, okay, and understand. Okay, now thank you so much for watching. Just take care of yourself.